Welcome to the show, the amazing, it's Anne-Marie and Nathan Dawe!
Yo.
Hey, hello.
How are you?
I'm good, man. How are you?
Not too bad. Tired.
Anne-Marie, have you seen what Nathan's rocking?
What?
He rolled through casual in a Givenchy hoodie.
Of course he did. That's how he rolls.
Well, it's usually Adidas, so I thought I'd make the effort.
It is normally Adidas. I'm a bit surprised, to be honest.
The worst thing about this is, Anne-Marie, you joined a little bit later, and Nathan was just saying he found it in his house. Who finds Givenchy? Just like, oh, God, I just found it, this little old thing.
But to back my point up, I said I've just moved house and everything's everywhere.
You did say
that. That's what I meant. Makes sense. I don't just have him knocking around the gap.
Say that. Nathan, you're in York, because we're doing this over Zoom now, listeners, to sort of give you a bit of an idea of how it's looking. Nathan, you're in your house, your new house. Mm-hmm. And Anne-Marie, where do we find you right now?
I'm in my same house.
same house.
But I am actually moving.
Oh, yeah.
So next time you see me, I might be in a different setting.
Are you moving to a big showbiz pop star mansion?
No.
Yeah. Yeah, she is. I've seen it.
I bet. It's outrageous.
Yeah, no, my big gaff is actually the one in the music video.
I knew it would be. What's the most exciting thing that you've got in that house, by the way, Anne-Marie? What's your most prized possession?
Lemon tree.
Wow, well done on keeping that alive.
Yeah, well, there's no lemons on it at the moment, but it's alive.
Yeah.
I'm really happy about. I really love my Hoover.
Okay.
Which Hoover you got?
That will come with me.
Is it
a Dyson?
It's a Dyson.
Okay.
Yeah, trust me, the best.
Real chat, I just got a shark hoover and it changed my life a little bit. None of that.
I was going to say, I'm Team Shark.
Unbelievable. No way.
Yeah.
Honestly, it doesn't fool you. It's unbelievable.
Nathan, are you aware of anti-wrap technology?
I've got the anti-wrap.
Wait, mate, what are you chatting about?
You are not getting any hairs in your hoover with that anti-wrap technology.
Yeah, but you're boys anyway, so like your hair ain't really... getting in the way,
it can do pet hair, it can do a lot,
and that's why you go and buy a shark right now.
I'm actually gonna get one now.
Hey, do you think we'll all get shark hoovers sent to us now?
Yeah, let's hope so.
They are expensive.
I got mine on offer anyway. This is not about this. Nathan, congratulations on the Brits nomination, that's pretty cool.
Thank you so much. Yeah, it was pretty mental, so thank you.
Come a long way from working in Primark.
Yes, not too bad. £4 an hour, 4 hours a week, earning £16, £3 to get the bus home, £1 to get lunch, £10 a week. Wasn't great, but yeah. I still speak to a lot of people that used to work there with me and that, so it's pretty cool, but Primark.
What you don't get in Primark?
Go on.
You want your bloody hoodies, do you?
No, you don't. You get £1 T-shirts. And then when people ask you if you've got their size, you go to the back and have a look and you just don't even look and then come back and say, no, we haven't got it your size.
Oh,
that's what we used to do.
I knew this happened. I hate it. I don't know how you feel about this. I hate when I go shopping and I'm like, oh, have you got one of those? And then like, unless it's out the front, we don't have it. At least go and look for me.
Oh, no, they do have it, especially in Primark. They don't not have anything. They've got everything.
Anne-Marie, what was your first job? What did you do before being an international best-selling pop star lady?
Well, I taught karate.
Did you?
Yeah, I was a karate teacher first. And then I worked in Ted Baker in House of Fraser.
Wow. Were you...
In Lakeside.
Were you good at that job, or were you a bit like, I don't want to be doing this, man?
I was just bad at every... Well, not karate. I was good at the karate one. But as soon as I was at college... I did Ted Baker at the weekends and I just was always late. But luckily the manager really liked me. So I kept the job for like a year and a half.
Amazing.
So that was long. And then like one day I always used to hide my phone in the store cupboard. Mm. And the boss people came down and found my phone in the store cupboard and was like, we have to look for your phone because there's thieving going on. I was like, no, you won't. And they went, we're going to look for your phone or you're fired. I went, see you later then.
Yeah, and your face.
Did you nick it? Be honest now.
I did nick a few things, yeah.
What was the best thing you got from Ted Baker?
No, I never used to steal from Ted Baker.
That you say that like you stole from other places, but never Ted Baker. It would never be Ted Baker. Nathan, talk about the Brit Award, by the way, nomination. You told your mum, right? You filmed yourself telling your mum about it.
Oh, God. This is so
it's going to be all day, isn't it?
Yeah. Don't think you can put something like that online and not have people like me question that all day. Is she a big fan of your work?
She likes it a bit, yeah.
Does she? Does she give feedback? I imagine mums would give feedback. My mum's brutal about my radio shows. She tells me, she goes, hey, I can tell when you're nervous. All right, mum, I'm trying my best.
Yeah. Well, it's your mum, she knows. But, you know, yeah, she's very proud. She's very proud. And I just get a lot of phone calls all the time saying, can you send a video to so-and-so's son or can you send a signature to so-and-so's son? I'm just bumped into someone. Say hello. That's what I get around this small little town with mum.
When your mum passes, she loves it. Phone, what are you expected to do? Hello, I'm Nathan.
I mean, obviously, I'm sure you must have it as well, Anne-Marie. And I don't know, you just say, hello, you're all right. That's it. You okay? Yeah, lovely. So, yeah, it's quite awkward sometimes, but no. I usually know them because it's such a small town. I'm like, yeah, I know, Steve. Like, you're right.
He's a plumber.
Yeah, literally. So, yeah, it's quite good.
Yeah, Anne-Marie, you must get a lot. I actually think I did this to you because I know your manager and I asked her to get a birthday message from my girlfriend from you. And I feel quite embarrassing that I did that now. Is it really annoying?
No, it's not annoying. Well, it's only annoying when I'm not dressed up for it and I'm not ready to do it. And I'm like, I literally have to put makeup on to do a video and then take it off.
And you forget.
Yeah. Yeah.
Putting makeup but it's on fine.
The one.
I love it. I love doing it. Like my mum and dad do it as well. And I sign stuff for people they talk to. So it's just cute, ain't it?
Mm. It is nice. It is really nice. Nathan, are you thinking about taking your parents to the Brit Awards? Tom Walker did that. Tom Walker was telling me he took his mum and dad for the first time. You should do it.
Did he win?
He won. That was the year he won.
Well,
that'd be good. Do you know what? I don't know how many people are going to be allowed to come yet. Because of obviously COVID, etc. And I've got a guest list that long right now waiting to come in. So mum and dad's definitely at the top of it, but I think we've got to try and sneak KSI and some of the label in first.
Oh yeah, people that actually, yeah, probably. Have you brought your parents along to anything cool, Anne-Marie? Have you blagged them in backstage anywhere?
Basically to all my London shows, yeah.
Yeah.
And some, I guess, some other little things, but they're happy sitting at the front. Actually, my dad likes the free booze in the back. So he does like coming backstage.
VIP.
Yeah. Yeah.
They
love it.
Are you on the free booze before going out there? Do you like to have a drink before you go on stage?
I can't. I can't do it because I'm a lightweight. So if I have one, my voice will be all over the place. I can't do it.
So professional.
I wish I could. Yeah. That would help me out a little bit with my nerves and that. But no, I can't do it until after I finish the show.
And talking about like nights out and things, are you both looking forward to lockdown ending? Nathan, what's the first night out you've got planned? Talk me through it in detail.
Detail? Well, I don't know because you won't know the bars that are around me, but just for elaborate reasons, pre-drinks at mine. And then taxi to pre-drinks bar, cocktails, porn star martinis, go to the club, get a dirty, horrible kebab, get food poisoning, come home. That is the plan.
Anne-Marie, what is your takeaway order? If we were going on a night out and it gets to about, I'm a lightweight, I'm 3 a.m, I'm done. What are you ordering?
It's either pizza or leftover Indian.
Oh, yeah.
Indian is the best.
What strength do I have? Because I had Indian last night and it was quite hot.
I'm totally no spice.
Korma.
That's a korma.
It's a korma.
Yeah, korma. Right, okay. I can do tikka masala.
Oh, God, don't push your boat out.
If you're feeling spicy.
You be careful.
Anne-Marie, I've got a question for you. And please don't try and like get out of this or find a clever answer. I want a proper answer, all right? Where are we at with the album?
Come on.
We're all right.
I've basically got one song left to master and then it's done.
Wow.
And that's like, I don't know if that makes sense to anyone, but
it's nearly finished.
Nearly there.
Yeah, it's nearly finished. So we pick songs, we mix them all, and then they all go to master and then it's literally done. So one song left to master is like a big sentence to say for me.
Mm. Have you?
Yeah, it's exciting.
Have you picked first singles? Have you picked names?
Yeah, I've got everything. Everything's done. The name of the album, the amount of songs, the collaborations, everything.
Is it a lockdown album or is it fun party vibes?
Both.
Yes.
It's everything.
I'm here for this. And Nathan, have you tried any of Anne-Marie's baking since you've been doing promo and making music?
No, we haven't, but I've heard about it and I do want to try it at some point, but I am probably the worst cook in Britain. So I made an omelette last night and burnt it and it was just horrible. So I just can't make anything. It's embarrassing. So I'm not going to judge anyone.
Hold on, Nathan. I don't want to pry too much here and feel free to tell me to do one. Are you single right now?
I am now, yeah, because I'm cooking.
Okay, yeah, so hold on. So you're wining and dining, you're going out on a date, you bring them back to yours. What are you sticking on that plate?
Whatever's in the freezer, because I go to Costco a lot and just fill the freezer with chicken nuggets, chips. Yeah. Funny story, actually, when I went to do a Costco shop, because it's the first time I've done a food shop, I got some steaks, like fresh steaks, and it said that you've got to use it by the Thursday. And I wanted to cook them on Friday. So I said to the guy, which I thought was a normal question, I said, can you freeze these? And he was like, well, yeah, of course you can. I guess, okay, so if I freeze them, how long would they last? He was like, 3 months. I said, okay, so in theory, if I freeze them tonight, I can use them on Friday if I get them out Thursday. He went, well, yeah, that's within 3 months. Looked at me like I was scum of the earth. And I was thinking, I don't know how to cook these things. I thought you have to defrost, I don't know, I'm useless. I don't know how to wash, cook, clean, iron. And yeah, I didn't know if you could freeze steaks or not, which is a stupid question, but because it said you got to use it by Thursday. I didn't know if you freeze it and you can get... Shall I just stop talking? That's embarrassing.
It really is a catch, everybody. He's the man that you want to be. You want to be... That must have been a dream to do that show. I watched it in my house. You made it look glamorous. You made it look great. It looked a lot of fun.
It was so good. I actually would do that once a week, just be in that tent and just... Yeah, it was brilliant. And I actually did okay, and I was a little bit annoyed that I didn't win, but, you know, James won.
Yeah. And finally, before you go, because I know you're really busy today, I just want to play a quick game called Sliding Door. thanks for laughing.
It's always my name, isn't it?
Yeah, it's always your name. So
there's a door.
All I need to know is the best person that has ever slid into your DMs in my game, Sliding Door. Anne-Marie, we'll start with you. Give me your best DM slide.
Well, the other day I realized the game had slid into my DMs. Yeah. And I'm a massive fan of him. And I didn't even realize because it filtered, I didn't follow. So it was like, and I was like, top requests. And he came up and I just lost my head.
Hold on. Hated to love it. The underdog's on top. Sliding Doors, who's the best person in there?
No one that exciting. Probably my mum when I got the Brit Award nomination. Oh my God. But no, I don't know. Probably some footballers in that, but I don't know. I've not known the game, so.
Okay. We'll take it. The new tune is out right now. It's called Way Too Long. It's the amazing Anne-Marie and Nathan Dawe, everybody.
Thank you.